So, Alice, can you start by introducing yourself?
My name is Alice. I go to the school.
So I noticed. Alice, are you aware that you were a suspect in the death of John Newbert?
I'm aware.
And did you murder Professor Newbert?
No.
And can you tell me who did?
No, I can't. But I can tell you what I think happened and who I think did it.
What is this? Why am I here?
You don't know. Cody, is it?
Look, I don't know who you are, but I can tell you I didn't do anything wrong. The only reason I'm here is because Alice agreed to be here.
You sound defensive, Cody. We're not rushing to any bold conclusions. We just want to ask you about Professor Newbert.
I can't answer your questions. I'm going to be late for chapter.
Listen, Cody. The sooner that you help me out, the sooner you can leave. I just need some answers.
Where's Alice? Is she okay?
Yes, Alice is fine. Why are you so worried?
I just wanted to make sure. Look, I don't have any answers for you.
Well, until you do, we're both staying right here. Introduce yourself.
My name is Jaden.
You're a student here? You're going to have to give me more information than that. Can you tell me about Professor Newbert? Well?
I can't talk about it.
Why? Why can't you talk about it?
I can't. I can't.
Nothing at all?
He was a creep.
A creep? How so?
I can't.
Jada, can you tell me why Professor Newbert is or was a creep? You are Felix Cooper, are you not, son?
Yeah, that's me.
What can you tell me about Professor Newbert?
Well, he may have had some favorites, but that is human nature. I never held it against him.
Did anyone else have problems with him?
Well, there were some girls in the class who were talking about how he was getting too close, but I never asked about that.
Right. Did the professor have any enemies in the class?
Now, how would I know that?
Just answer the question, son.
Well, he graded okay. He isn't, or I guess wasn't, a very disliked member of the community. And I'm not your son.
Was that sass?
No, sir. It's just a fact.
And where were you, Felix, after class on April 11th?
Am I a suspect in his murder?
Well, we don't know until you answer the question, do we? Margaret, were you at the gym when you got the call that Professor Newbert was dead and that you needed to report to the police station?
No, I was on my way back to my room after Mr. Newbert's class. Why would you think that?
Never mind. So you had just been in Professor Newbert's class right before you got the call. Was Newbert acting strangely today?
I mean, not really. He was always kind of weird. Like, he was always kind of gross.
Can you elaborate on what you mean by gross?
Like, he was the type of professor who would, like, when you were taking a test and he would come stand in front of you or behind you and you felt like he was kind of looking down your shirt, stuff like that.
Have you heard any of the other students complain about Professor Newbert's actions?
Oh yeah, definitely. Like, all the girls noticed it, but even some of the guys did too. But it was the kind of creepiness where, like, you didn't know if he was actually being weird or if it could just be contributed to a lack of social skills.
Can you tell me what happened leading up to the day when Professor Newbert was found dead in his office? You were the one who we received the 911 call from, correct?
That's right.
But when you called, you had no idea that he was in his office, dead.
No. Like I said on the phone, that's why I reported him, because he's a fucking creep.
Would you consider yourself to be a feminist?
Of course. Would you?
Would you kill Professor Newbert because he was inappropriate with the female students in his class?
He was a fucking creep. He deserved to be fired or something for what he did. But of course I did not kill him.
Leah Davies, star of the track team. You're probably one of the most athletic students here. Probably one of the only students who could physically overpower Professor Newber if they had a chance. Would you agree?
Yes, sir, I would agree, but I'm not a violent person. I could never bring myself to commit a violent act like that.
You also weren't receiving very good grades in Professor Newbert's class. Maybe you knew he wasn't going to let you pass, so you ended him so that you wouldn't be suspended.
Are you serious? You can say the exact same thing about Cody, but I don't see him out there wearing handcuffs. Everybody thinks I'm such an intimidating person, but I would never risk myself over a couple of grades.
I apologize, Leah. I'm just pressing you because I want justice for this, and you are the most likely elite suspect.
You can't sit there and judge who you think I am or what I'm like. If I'm not at practice, I'm studying my ass off every single day. I can promise you I had absolutely nothing to do with Professor Newbert's death.
So what the hell is going on? I get this elusive email telling me to show up here. There's a bunch of students out there.
Miss, please just sit down. Well, you know why you're here.
Obviously not. That's what I'm trying to tell you. What the hell is going on?
Miss, we're investigating a murder. You might be a suspect.
Who died?
You seriously don't know? Tell me, do you ever go to class?
Occasionally. I don't really see the point.
So you don't know that Professor Newbert is dead?
Professor Newbert is dead?
Yes.
Oh.
Jonah Martin, I presume?
Yes, sir. How are we doing tonight, Mr. Investigator?
Fine, thank you. You seem pretty laid back for a student whose teacher was found dead.
Whoa, I was devastated about that. I didn't have anything to do with it either.
Well, can you tell me what Professor Newbert was like then?
Well, Mr. Investigator, I can't really recall what he was like, but I do remember the first class. It was pretty boring.
How can you not remember what your professor of nearly a year was like?
Let's just say that my track record for attendance isn't exactly what we'd call exemplary.
So you don't know anything about your teacher at all?
I do remember after our first class, he asked a couple of girls to stay after, but that was about it.
Interesting. Well, thank you, Jonah.
Of course, Mr. Investigator, it was nice meeting you again.
Start going to class!
Unlikely.
You said that Professor Newbert was acting inappropriately towards some of the students in his class. Did you do anything about this? Why didn't you report him?
We did report. We all did.
Who was part of this group that reported him?
Me, Cody, and Jonah.
Why you three?
Well, I hate him. He's a pervert. But also, Jada, she's the type, you know, she seems shy all the time. Sometimes she even seems like she's in trouble when she did absolutely nothing wrong. So I saw how fearful she was, and I instantly assumed it might have been because of Professor Newbert. So I asked her about it one day, and she finally admitted to me what was going on and that it was him. And so then we became friends, and I sat beside her in class.
Did you three start spending time together outside of class?
I hung out with both of them, but never both of them at the same time.
Why didn't you just drop the class? You are a senior after all. Surely you had enough credits.
It's a gen ed that a bunch of us seniors push off until last minute. Are you insisting that I really not take a class because the professor's a creep?
So nothing changed after you reported him, but you, Cody, and Jada had a support system. Correct.
Yes. We called and they said that they were going to do something or they were going to talk to him, but it seemed like nothing ever happened. Nothing changed.
And after the school did nothing, it never crossed your minds to take matters into your own hands to punish yourself.
Look, I did not kill him, but at this point I wish I had.
Alice just told us about the assault. You knew this whole time and you didn't tell me.
I was gonna tell you, but I wanted to protect Alice and her friend Jada. Once Jada told me, I thought I could go talk to Professor Newberg on my own.
So you killed him when you went to talk to him?
No, of course not. I just went to go talk to him. I told him I was gonna go to the administration, and he physically threatened me. Then I told him I was gonna go to the cops, and he shouted at me to leave. I called the cops once I left the building.
I understand. Well, is there anybody else that you think did it?
No, it wasn't Jada, it wasn't Alice, and it sure as hell wasn't me. I need to go make sure Alice is okay. Can I leave?
You're free to go. Genesis Brown, correct, miss?
Yeah, this place is kind of creepy.
Please let me ask some questions, Miss Brown.
I didn't ask a question.
What can you tell me about Professor Newberg?
He wasn't a bad teacher. He got pretty decent grades in his class.
Did he ever do anything that seemed off to you?
Off?
Yes, different, odd, out of the ordinary, or something you didn't think was 100% correct.
I mean, he would lowball my grade a lot. Like, I thought I turned in pretty decent work, like A material, but...
How was it visiting his office?
I mean, he kind of rubbed me the wrong way. Like, he would keep staring at the door. I always try to keep it open.
So, eventually, everything had to come to a boiling point. What happened? Jada, can you please tell me what happened?
Okay, I'll tell you.
Jada?
One day, Newbert asked if I could talk to him after class.
Go on.
Obviously, I didn't want to, but when we were alone in the classroom, he asked if I could come up to his office and talk to him.
Did he say why?
To talk about my last paper or something. I thought I was in trouble. I thought I had done badly on the last paper. Alice and Cody were standing outside the classroom waiting for me, and when I told them that I was going up to his office with him, they offered to go with me. I said no. I could tell that Alice was reluctant to let me go with him. But when we got up there, there was a big window overlooking the lawn, and I could see Alice and Cody standing out there in the grass waiting for me.
What happened in the office?
Turned away from me and started going through his files. So I looked out the window. When I turned around, he was standing there waiting for me. And he started holding my paper and started talking about it.
Then what happened?
When he was done, I looked out the window, and that's when I felt him come up behind me. And
yes?
And he grabbed me. He grabbed my butt.
Then what did you do?
I jumped away from him, and I slapped his hand away.
Did you make any noise?
I think I screamed a little, then I ran. For a moment, after I slapped his hand away, I was looking into his eyes, and it was like I was looking into the eyes of a monster. I couldn't think anything except that I needed to get out of there. So I ran away.
Then what happened? Were Alice and Cody still waiting for you?
They were. I ran up to them, and they knew something was wrong. Cody was yelling, and Alice hugged me and asked me what happened, so I told them.
Were you hysterical in any way?
Crying?
That comes with hysteria, typically.
It was like I couldn't react. Cody was standing there yelling and cursing Newbert. And Alice was saying that she was going to call the police, and then she did.
Do you remember what she said to the police?
Everything that I had told her, and that we tried to report him to the campus police. They told us that we should stand outside the building. It was like seconds later and they were there. They were kind. One of them was talking to me and asking me what happened, while the other two went inside the building. She was calm. I don't know how much time had passed, but she was talking. She was still talking to me. Then, over her walkie-talkie, I heard two other policemen talking to her. She tried to back away from me, but I had already heard what they had said. But Newbert was dead.
I went to go see him during his office hours, where he would be open. I knocked on the door and didn't respond, so I just left.
Do you think any of the other students here did it?
After sitting and listening to them, no way. It's a shame what happened to Professor Newbert, but he didn't deserve to die for it.
So you condone what he did?
No way. What he did was basically suicide.